On behalf of the plaintiff respondent, it has been argued that as to what is the rate of rent of the accommodation is a pure question of fact, and once the court below has returned a finding on the rate of rent, the revisional court ought not to interfere with the said finding in exercise of its revisional powers, and therefore the revision is liable to dismiss stock. No doubt as to what was the agreed rate of rent for the premises in question is a question of fact, but a finding on a question of fact must be returned by appreciating the evidence that has been led by the parties and not by simply narrating what evidence has been led stock. A finding returned after consideration of all relevant evidence on question of fact is not ordinarily to be interfered with by a revisional court unless the same is perverse or is based on taking inadmissible evidence into consideration or is based on misreading of evidence stock. But for there to be a consideration of relevant evidence, the evidence led must be appreciated by application of a judicial mind stock. When both sides in a suit or proceeding lead their evidence, the court is required to appreciate the evidence and thereafter to draw its conclusion on the issue. Stop. Essential feature of appreciation is the rationale behind accepting one evidence over the other. Stop. That rationale must be reflected in the judgment oblique order. Stop. Therefore, the duty of a court of fact does not get over by disclosing as to what evidence has been led by the parties before it, but is discharged when it returns a finding after appreciation oblique analysis of the evidence stock. A finding which has been returned without application of judicial mind or without analyzing the evidence as to why one evidence has more weight than the other, or without considering the entire relevant evidence led before the court, renders the finding vitiated. Stop. Para. In the instant case, there was no documentary evidence either in the shape of a rent note or a rent agreement or a rent receipt as regards agreed rate of rent. Stop. Both sides had led oral evidence in support of their respective cases. Stop. Apart from oral evidence, the defendant had placed the quinquennial municipal assessment record of 2003-09 to suggest that the annual value of the premises was ₹11,520. Stop. The basis of such annual assessment was brought on record through the statement of DW3, who was tax inspector Nagar Nigam. Stop. As to why the evidence of the plaintiff was more acceptable as compared to the evidence of the defendant is not at all reflected from the order impugned. Stop. Moreover, the testimony of DW4 and DW5, who have deposed in respect of the agreed rate of rent being ₹500 per month, has not been considered at all. Stop. Under the circumstances, this court is of the view that the finding returned by the court below on issue number 1, that is agreed rate of rent of the premises in suit, is vitiated and therefore the same required reconsideration. Stop. Pair. As to what weight is to be attached to the testimony of the plaintiff and defendant witnesses as well as to the municipal assessment record is in the domain of the trial court, and therefore this court finds it appropriate not to express any opinion on the merits of the evidence stop. However, since this court is of the view that the finding on the rate of rent for the premises in question requires reconsideration, the impugned judgment and decree, which turns on the crucial issue as to what was the agreed rate of rent between the parties, deserves to be set aside stop for the reasons recorded herein above. The revision is allowed stop. The judgment and decree passed by the court below is hereby set aside stop. The matter is remanded back to the court below to decide the case afresh in accordance with law, preferably within a period of 2 months from the date of filing of certified copy of this order stop. There shall be no order as to cost stop.